Here's a typical Douglas anecdote that not only entertains, but also makes a point. It's called the cream separator, and Tommy Douglas uses it to show the inequitable distribution of income, of how easily people can become the victims of a worn-out economic system.
I used to visit and farm homes, particularly around mealtime. And if I got in around dinner time, of course, everybody in the family was busy. They were unhitching the horses. They were pumping water. They were milking the cows. They were pitching down the hay and the oat sheaves. Somebody else was out gathering the eggs. Somebody else was feeding the pigs and the chickens. Everybody had something to do. Even the youngsters were given the job doing something, such as gathering eggs or feeding the chickens. And here I was, right off the city streets, you know. I didn't know what to do. I'd say, well, give me something to do. Well, nobody was going to trust this city boy with milking a good cow. They gave me the one job, you know, that anybody could do. They gave me the job of turning the handle on the old cream separator. Any of you ever turned the handle on a cream separator? Well, you know, it's quite an experience. I got to be pretty good at it. I got to the place where I could tell you how many verses of Onward Christian Soldiers it takes to put a pan of milk through this thing. And as I was turning the handle, and they were pouring in the milk, and I could see the cream coming out of one spout and the skim milk coming out of the other spout, one day it finally penetrated my thick Scotch head that this cream separator is exactly like our economic system. Here are the primary producers, the farmers and the fishermen and the loggers. They're pouring in the milk. And here are the workers. Whether they work on the railroad or go down to the mines or sail ships or work in a store or a bank or teach school, clerk in the store, work in a hospital, they're the people whose services make the economy go round, and they're turning the handle. So here you have it. Primary producer puts in the milk. People who work with hand and brain turn the handle. And then I thought, but there's another fellow here somewhere. There's a fellow who owns this cream separator. And he's sitting on a stool with a cream spout in his mouth. And the primary producer and the worker, they take turns on the skim milk spout. And they don't like skim milk. Nobody likes skim milk. And they blame it on each other. And the worker says, if those farmers and fishermen, you know, would work a little harder, well, I wouldn't be drinking this skim milk. And the fishermen and the farmers say, if those workers didn't demand a 40-hour week, didn't want such high wages, I wouldn't have to live on this blue milk. But you know, they're both wrong. The farmers and the fishermen have produced so much that we don't know what to do with it. We've got surpluses of foodstuffs. And the workers, they've produced so well that today nearly 500,000 of them are unemployed. The fault isn't with the worker. It isn't with the primary producer. The fault is with this machine. This machine was built to give skim milk to the worker and the primary producer, and to give cream to the corporate elite. And as a matter of fact, it doesn't always do that. Because every once in a while, this little fellow sitting on the stool with the cream spout in his mouth gets indigestion. And he says, boys, stop the machine. We've got a recession. The worker, you're laid off. You can go on unemployment insurance. And after that, on welfare. And he says to the farmers and the fishermen, you know, we don't need your stuff. Take it back home. Then he sits for a while. Indigestion gets better. He burps a couple of times. He says, all right, boys, start the machine. Happy days are here again. cream for me and skim milk for both of you. Now, what the Democratic Socialist Party have been saying to Canadians for a long time is that the time has come in this land of ours for the worker and the primary producer to get their hands on the regulator of the machine so that it begins to produce homogenized milk in which everybody will get a little cream.